ask you a question?
Sure.
What is anthropology?
I don't know.
What's anthropology?
Okay.
What is anthropology?
I don't really know, but I know it has to do with like artifacts and like, you know, things back then.
Hey.
Yeah.
Do you mind if I ask you a question?
Sure.
Do you mind telling me what anthropology is? Hello?
Yeah.
I was asking you something. What's anthropology?
Indiana Jones?
Can't seem to get past the Indiana Jones stereotype. But today, we're going to change that. Let's see if we can find someone that can help us out.
Come in. Hey, Keturah, what's going on?
Hi, Dr. K. I was wondering if I could ask you a couple questions.
Sure.
Can you explain to us what anthropology is in the simplest of terms?
Sure. So anthropology, simply put, is the study of humans. Anthropologists approach this study broadly or holistically. We seek to understand various dimensions of the human experience.
So, how do anthropologists study human beings?
Well, that would depend on what type of anthropologist you're talking about.
You mean to say that there's more than one type of anthropologist?
Yes. Well, in the United States, there's 5 main types of anthropologists.
Dr. K.A. went on to tell me the name of 5 main areas of specializations within anthropology. Biological anthropology, cultural anthropology, linguistic anthropology, archaeology, and applied anthropology.
So how an anthropologist studies human beings will depend on what subdiscipline they belong to.
Well, in that case, we should go speak with each type of anthropologist to learn more.
Biological anthropology is a branch of anthropology dealing with human variability, adaptation, and evolution. In human evolution, we study humans and their fossil relatives. And in modern human biology, we incorporate the use of culture and behavior, therefore making this field a social science.
How do biological anthropologists study human beings?
Well, one of the methods we employ includes field work and lab work. So in field work, we go out prospecting and hunting for fossils. We bring these fossils back in the labs and compare them with apes and other already known human remains to see patterns in the evolution of our species.
All right, so now that we know a little bit more about biological anthropology, let's see what we can find out about the other subfields.
Cultural anthropology is the study of the cultural and behavioral dimensions of being human.
How do cultural anthropologists study human beings?
Cultural anthropologists study a group of people by immersing themselves into their everyday life. Typically, what that involves is you would have to go and live with that group of people for an extended period of time.
Stay anywhere between 6 to 12 months. And then during that time, you get to learn about that group's everyday life and their culture, and you collect information about that group using different data collection techniques, such as informal conversations, formal interviews, You also do something known as participant observation, which is where you're not only observing that group of people in their everyday context, but also partaking in their various rituals and everyday life activities as a way of learning about them. Other than that, cultural anthropologists collect information by taking lots of photographs and making videos. And to be honest, a lot of what we do is just hang out.
Wow, I had no idea that anthropologists did all that. It sounds like a lot of fun. Let's go see what else we can find.
Linguistic anthropology is the study of language in its social context, or the study of the relationships between language and culture.
How do linguistic anthropologists study human beings?
Well, we always study with linguistic structure because one cannot understand the connections between language and culture unless one has a very good understanding of what is in the language. So that means that sometimes we have to do something that is called linguistic elicitation, and that is basically you will be sitting down with a native speaker of the language that you are interested in studying, and you will be asking questions. So how do you say this, how do you say that in this language, until you collect a large amount of data. And then you begin to organize and analyze that amount of data, and you see that patterns begin to emerge. So you're able to describe how sound is organized in this particular language, or how what are the rules that are used in this language to put sentences together. So once you've done that, then the next step is to connect that with a larger cultural context. And for that, we're going to be doing pretty much what any other anthropologist would do, which is doing a lot of participant observation.
Okay, so who knew that you could learn so much about humans through language and communication? On to the next subfield.
Archaeology is the study of the human past based upon material evidence and its context.
How do archaeologists study human beings?
Archaeologists study people of the past by examining the stuff that they leave behind. Often, archaeology takes place outdoors.
At an archaeological site, there archaeologists conduct excavations to recover artifacts, objects made, manipulated, modified by people, and to try to understand the relationship across space between those artifacts. The real work, though, begins at the lab. There, archaeologists study the objects and the maps, the photographs, the drawings that the field archaeologists provide. And the idea is to try and better understand who made those objects, who used them, and then ultimately how, why, and when they were discarded.
That's archaeology, and it was quite different from the stereotypes that many of us had in mind. So, with that being said, we have one more type of anthropology that we need to learn about. Let's go find the right person to speak with.
Really just means putting anthropology to practical use. Anthropologists in each of the four subfields have specialized sets of skills, tools for studying humans, specialized sets of knowledge about humans. Whenever those anthropological skills are applied to help solve real-world problems, that's applied anthropology.
How do applied anthropologists study human beings?
Well, applied anthropology is a little bit different than the other four subfields in that it includes and encompasses all of them. So what distinguishes applied anthropology in terms of studying humans is less a question of how than a question of why. Applied anthropology is all about solving real-world problems, and that means that applied anthropological research is taken on with particular kinds of goals in mind, specifically of producing findings that are immediately relevant and directly applicable toward whatever the project is at hand, whether it's developing new policy recommendations, implementing a new program within a particular community. The purpose of applied anthropological research is to produce straightforward, directly relevant, immediately applicable findings.
Okay, so now you know that there are many different types of anthropologists, and they study humans in the past and present in a variety of different ways. So the next time that pesky Indiana Jones image pops into your head, you should shove it aside and think of these five.